Hi guys, and welcome in to another edition of Math in a Hoodie. I am ready to break down some math concepts. Today we're talking about improper fractions. So let's go ahead and figure out exactly what an improper fraction is, and then we'll learn step by step on how to reverse it into a mixed number, okay? It's really easy, guys. I know you're gonna catch on really quick. So I have three different fractions on the board, and I just want us to review and see which ones are improper fraction. So the definition of an improper fraction is one that is top heavy, okay? And what they mean by that is the top number or the numerator is bigger than the denominator or the downstairs number. Okay, so obviously this first one is, okay, 31 is obviously bigger than 6. So this is an improper fraction. Now, why is it improper? Well, because we know that a fraction is talking about a part of a whole, right? It's not quite a whole number, it's a part of a whole. So the denominator is supposed to tell us how many parts are in that particular fraction. So the denominator is telling us there's 6 parts. So we just made a pie into 6 parts. The numerator or the top number is supposed to tell us how many we're talking about or how many we have, right? So can we have 31 parts if there's only 6 total? That just wouldn't make sense, would it? We can't have more parts than there are total. So it doesn't make sense. It's improper. We can't take 31 parts when there's only 6 to begin with, okay? So it's improper. So we need to go ahead and make it into a mixed number, which would then make sense and it then is practical. So this one is an improper fraction because it is top heavy. 31 is obviously bigger than 6, okay? Let's move to the second number. We have 9/12. Now, is the big number on the top or the bottom? The denominator is the big one, right? So this is actually a proper fraction. This is acceptable because they're talking about 9 parts of 12 total. And we can do that, okay? So that one's proper. Let's look at this last one, 21/7. Where's the big number here? Is this one top heavy? It is, because 21 is larger than 7. So this one is improper, okay? And this one is improper as well. So it's really easy to identify an improper fraction because you're looking to make sure it's top heavy. Now, when you are computing fractions and your answer is an improper fraction, you can't just leave it like that, right? Because that's an incorrect answer. So if you're computing a fraction and you end up with a proper fraction and you can't simplify it any further, then you're done. But if you compute and you have an improper fraction, then we need to go ahead and turn that into a mixed number. And that's what we're going to learn about next. So now that you know how to identify improper and proper fractions, let's go ahead and learn the steps to make an improper fraction into a mixed number. Okay, guys, so here is our first fraction. Okay, it's 46/9. We can identify right away that it is an improper fraction because the numerator or the top number is larger than the bottom. So this fraction does not make sense, does it? We can't take 46 pieces when there's only 9 to start with. So we need to go ahead and change this into a mixed number. And let me show you the steps to do that, okay? So first you're going to divide the denominator into the numerator. How many times can 9 go into 46? Okay, how many times can 9 go into 46? Well, it can go into 5 times, because if we did it 5 times, 5 times 9 is 45. How many would be left over, guys? 1. So what do we do with the remainder? We make the remainder our numerator, and we keep the same denominator. Do you see how we did that? So the first step is to divide the denominator into the numerator, and that's going to be our whole number because it can go in 5 whole times, okay? It can't go in any more than that, can it? It can only go in a little bit. There's only one whole number left. So with that remainder, we're gonna make that our numerator and then bring over the same denominator. So it's 5 1/9. And once you've moved it into the mixed number, then your answer would be correct, okay? Let's try a different one. Okay, guys, so for the next fraction that's improper, we have 10/4. Now, obviously, this is not a practical fraction, okay? We can't take 10 parts when there's only 4 to start with. So we need to turn it into a mixed number, okay? So step number 1 is to divide the denominator into the numerator. How many times can 4 go into 10 evenly? Well, 4 times 1 is 4. 4 times 2 is 8. If we did 4 times 3, that would go over, right? Because 4 times 3 is 12. So evenly, we can just go twice. So 2 times 4 is 8. And that gives us a remainder of 2. So it can go in 2 times, which is going to be our whole number, right? And then we're going to take our remainder, and that'll be our numerator. And then we keep the same denominator. 2 2/4. Now, can we simplify this at all? We can't simplify the whole number, right? But we can go ahead and simplify that fraction, can't we? How many times, what could we simplify it by? Well, we could simplify it by 2. 2 divided by 2 is 1. 4 divided by 2 is 2. So there we go. 4/10 turns into 2 1/2. Okay, let's do that a couple more times. I know there are a few steps to remember in this one, so let's try another one. Okay, guys, so before we move on, I've written the steps down and abbreviated for space, but let's go ahead and go through them. So here we have another fraction, 15/6. We know it's improper because it's top heavy, and there's no way we could take 15 when there's only 6 to begin with, right? Okay, so let's go through the steps. The first step is we're going to divide the denominator into the numerator. So our denominator is 6, and our numerator is 15. How many times can 6 go into 15 evenly? Well, 6 times 1 is 6. 6 times 2 is 12. 6 times 3 is 18. So that's too much. So let's stick with 2. 6 times 2 was 12. Okay, now step number 2. Our answer is going to be our whole number. Okay, so our answer was 2. 6 can go into 15 2 times evenly. So that 2 is going to be our whole number. Okay. Step number 3 is our remainder is now our numerator. So what was our remainder, guys? How many was left over? 3. So that 3 is now going to become our numerator, okay? And step 4, we keep the same denominator. So our denominator is 6. That's going to go over here. We have 2 3/6. Now, this would be your first answer, but what can we do to this? Okay, we can't simplify the whole number, can we? That's just gonna be a 2, but could we simplify the fraction? We could. We could simplify that each by 3, and that makes our new fraction 1/2, right? Because 6 divided by 3 is 2, and 3 divided by 3 is 1. So your answer is 2 1/2. See how we did that? So there are 4 steps, and I guess we should put number 5 to simplify if possible, okay? Because you don't, not every time will you be able to simplify. So there you go, okay? There's a few steps, so let's go ahead and try some more. Okay, guys, so here's our next improper fraction, and we're just gonna follow the steps, okay? So we have 52/5. Okay, obviously we can't take 52 pieces if the pie only has 5 to start with, right? So we need to, number one, divide the denominator into the numerator. So how many times can 5 go into 52? Well, if we know how to multiply by 10, we know that 5 times 10 is 50. Okay, and 11 times 5 is 55. So 11 is going to be too high, isn't it? So our answer is going to be 10. Okay, and how many, because our answer is going to equal our whole number, our remainder is going to be our numerator. How many is left over? So 5 times 10 was 50. How many is left over? 2, isn't it? So that's going to be our new numerator. Okay, now we're going to keep the same denominator, which is 5. So we have 10 and 2 fifths. Now we just need to see if we can simplify. Can we simplify 10 and 2 fifths? Can we simplify this fraction any further? We can't. So our answer is 10 and 2 fifths. Okay, are you guys getting it? Let's try one more, okay? Okay, guys, this is the last one we're going to do. We have an improper fraction of 29 over 3, okay? We're going to start with number 1, where we divide the denominator into the numerator. How many times can 3 go into 29? Well, if we know our multiples of 3, we know that 3 times 7 is 21. We can go higher. 3 times 8 is 24. We can go higher. 3 times 9 is 27. 3 times 10 would be 30. Oops, that would be too high, wouldn't it? So let's do 3 times 9. So we're going to write the 9 there. That's our whole number, okay? Okay, number 3, the remainder is our numerator. So 3 times 9 was 27, wasn't it? We have 29 to start with. How many is left over, guys? 2. So that's our new numerator, okay? Now, we're going to keep the same denominator as step 4 tells us. So we're going to move the 3 over. And then 5, we're going to check to see if we can simplify. Can we simplify 2/3? No, we can't. So our answer is 9 2/3. So as you get further into fractions, sometimes there are detailed steps in order to get to the answer. Sometimes you just can't see the answer when you're dealing with fractions or improper fractions. And that's okay. Take your time, do each step, and you'll get the right answer. Okay? So I hope this video has helped you understand improper fractions a little bit better. You guys have a good day. We'll see you next time on Math in a Hoodie.